Hey there, YouTubers. Jim from Ohio here. Just wanted to give you the next update of my solar project. And I did finally get the time to start building my second rack. This is going to be for the three panels that I'm going to use for my hot water heating system. And wanted to just show you what I did to put it together. Did this one a little bit different from the other one, and the reason for that is this rack over here is a stationary rack that'll never move. I wanted to make this one so that it's adjustable so that I can change the angle of the panels with the season, since we're going to be wanting to heat water all year round, and it'll be important that I get the best angle of the panels to collect the most sunlight. So a couple things that I did different here. I did, the posts are pretty much the same as I did with this rack. I did a 2x8x12 foot beam across the top. What I did different here is, you can see right here, I used a couple strap hinges. These are heavy duty strap hinges, just from the local Home Depot. And I didn't use the screws that came with these. Instead, I used bolts and washers to go all the way through, and I wanted to make sure that it was good and secure. On the back, just to make sure that nothing pulled through the wood, I did go ahead and put nuts and washers, including a lock washer, and I cut down a piece of the smaller superstrut just to give the wood a little more strength, a little more support, keep everything nice and straight. And there's no way that those bolts will pull out of there. So with it that way, and with the hinge on top, I should be able to change it with the season. So right now I've got it in the spring and fall configuration. You'll notice back here on the braces that I have, I've got enough room to push it more this way, which would cause a greater tilt, closer to the 90 degree angle that I would use during the summertime when the sun's directly overhead. I can just pull it back this way, which would increase the angle, so when the sun's lower in the sky during the winter time, I'll be able to collect more sunlight then. So this is the heavy duty super strut that I used here, and I used just regular bolts, washers and nuts, and did put a lock wash on everything to keep it good and tight. So I used two of those for each of the panels that I'll be mounting. These come in 10-foot lengths. I did cut it down. I didn't want that to stick up too high on the top and possibly cause shadowing when the sun's lower in the sky on this rack. And I didn't want it to stick out too far on the bottom and have somebody accidentally walk into it. You can see we've got watermelons growing here, and so this is a part of our garden we're going to continue to use, and I just didn't want to have an accident with anything. Yeah, that's about it, other than the way that I mounted these. Once again, I took a piece of the super strut, cut it down, drilled a couple holes in it, and mounted it onto the 2x4 that I've got running across here. And so just by loosening this bolt right here, and I'll have to do that with all four of those. By loosening those, I should be able to adjust this back this way. So that's about it. I did use the same type of fasteners in the channel. It's a channel nut on a spring. Same way I mounted the panels over there. I'll mount them here. I've got those one at the top and one at the bottom here for each of the panels. But that's about it. I'm hoping to get the panels mounted tomorrow. And then once I do that, I'll give another update on the hybrid hot water heating system that I plan on putting together. Well, take care, and thanks for watching.